प्रैक्टिकली इन टूडेज टाइम्स हाउ इज इट दैट यू डिजाइन योर रियाज? इज देयर अ स्ट्रैटेजी दैट यू फॉलो इफ यू हैव अ टाइम कंस्ट्रेंट? तो स्पेशली फॉर योर खरज, आई हैव हर्ड योर खरज, इट इज इनक्रेडिबल.
I don't have a very special practice for kharaj, but yes, I do some Western exercises for all the three octaves. And if I'm singing some ghazal or learning something like a ghazal or some. It's very, very inspiring to see someone passionately doing something like live demi, which is a gift to musicians.
There was a question. Can we maybe bring in another surprise guest? Yes, of course.
Oh!
Another crazy girl.
Hello.
Are you doing it again? Are you doing it again, Shakti?
That was so hilarious. Oh my god. How are you?
Hi, Namaste.
Hi, Neeratai.
She is another crazy young artist that I
come on. I'm just so happy to meet you both virtually because it's been a really long time. Met you both. Oh, thank you. And I have been listening to this interview since it started, and it's a pleasure to listen to you both. And you, तुम दोनों को पता है कि मैं कितनी बड़ी fan हूँ तुम्हारी. तो I really admire you both as artists, and I really love you for the amazing people that you are.
Oh. Thank you, Sharayu. Thank you. There's something about Sharayu that I would like to say. She and I go back a long way. I mean, it's been like 7-8 years now that we know each other. And I don't know. I just love this. There's some kick that she gets when she's on stage. That, okay, this is my moment and I have to give it all. I've never heard Sharayu hold anything back while she's performing, and that's her biggest strength.
That's the high that you were talking about, right, Hargun? Mm-hmm. That it's just something else, and वैसा किसी और circumstance में I don't know, I have experienced it anywhere else. So,
when we
and Hargun, continue.
See, I was saying that when we were doing C2N and she used to sing Kannada there in this the NMSCC, that the Great Indian Music that you mentioned, and at one or two places she would just like take off and do some crazy tan, and I would be like, matlab on stage, right, you can't be doing this to someone. you can't follow that, but I've done that because her fault. We did.
That was a blast. We had so much fun together in that season. That wasn't the first time I met Hargun. I met her at one of her shows with Ranjit Barot sir at NCPA. That was the first time I met her. Of course, I had heard her music before, and during C2N we had such great fun, and I usually take a lot of time to open up to people, and we just sort of connected in a second. That's all it took. So yeah, we had a really good time. So
nice.
Yeah, just going to say hi, and itna acha interview chal raha hai, I won't take much of your time, and it was great talk to you both after a really, really long time, and I hope to see you in person very soon.
Yeah, let's do that.
I would love to have Sharayu sometime on Kahani.
Yeah.
I would really love that. And thank you so much, Satyajitji, for having me here.
Yes. Thank you, Sharayu, for being there.
Thank you.
Pleasant surprise it is, and it's so nice to see this genuine appreciation for each other. What I'm liking about it is, we've come down to the point that we can appreciate each other without getting insecure, and that is very important. And that energy is very important.
I know.
So. Nice. Thank you so much, Sharon.
Thank you
for joining us.
Thank you. You both. Bye.
Bye. Anyway, yeah, we've had so many nice guests today. Gulraj, Ashwin, Sharayu, all of them. And I was just coming to another question is, when you're performing so much, when you're doing so many things, practically in today's times, how is it that you design your years? Is there a strategy that you follow if you have a time constraint? So especially for your courage, I've heard your courage. It is incredible. So what is it that you do for your courage? And because you perform so many varied genres, so how, if you have a limited time space, what is it that you like to attack when you do your riyaz?
Honestly, I don't have a fixed regime sort of a thing. This is which I should be having technically, but I don't. But whatever is going on, I mean, if I have to do 10 things, I have to do those 10 things. Kuch pehle, kuch baad mein hai na. So I would take one thing at a time and do that to the best of my ability, complete it. There's nothing that I do for courage a lot, honestly, because that sort of natural texture that my voice has. Jaise how you sing ekdam, you know, so mellifluous and so effortlessly in the middle and the higher octave, which I can't imagine doing at all. But I think that's just like how we are different as human beings and how our bodies and are different and voices are unique. I don't have a very special practice for courage, but yes, I do some Western exercises for
Western exercises.
Which do all the three octaves. And if I'm singing some ghazal or learning something like a ghazal or some song which is very deeply rooted in the Indian tradition of music, then I try to explore each and every whatever the nuances of it and try to learn it. But I don't honestly have a fixed regime. I'm really struggling to make one.
No, neither do I. I mean, that's why I was just curious to find out what is it that, because riyaz is something, I also write music columns, and that is the topic that I'm currently writing about. I've written one part and I'm going to write the second part. And I've been having discussions about riyaz with many artists to find out. And the common point that comes to me is we should not be liking our own riyaz. Is my takeaway from all these conversations and my own thought process, that if you like your own riyaz, it means you're staying in the comfort zone and doing the same thing.
Yeah, because even if you with these exercises, I started doing Merukhan some time back, you know, for permutation combination in 4 and then 5. 5 I barely could do like 1, because that becomes like mathematics if you see. So combinations, so shuru mein to you, because you're mentally, you know, very invested in it, because you're figuring out ki main kya next kya phrase hai aur kya gaana hai. तो वो ठीक है, बट वेन यू गेट यूज टू इट यू आर लाइक सारेगा मैं लगा रही हूँ, वो उतना सिस्टम में आने के बाद इट लूजेज द इम्पैक्ट समहाउ. तो टू गेट आउट ऑफ दैट एंड डू समथिंग न्यू ऑल द टाइम इज वॉट आई एम aiming to do, but I don't know if I'm doing the right thing or not. But okay. Doing the same thing definitely is not something which I prefer.
Yes, yes. And there's no right thing and there's no wrong thing according to me. I think following your own gut, and I as an artist, I guess you know the best what is it that you need, what is it that you need to work on. Aur aap phir ek point ke baad khud ke liye वो चैलेंजेस सेट करते जाते हैं एंड यू ट्राई डिजाइनिंग एक्सरसाइजेस फॉर योर ओन सेल्फ एंड दिस इज हाउ वी ऑल गो अबाउट इट.
एग्जैक्टली लिसनिंग टू पीपल लाइक यू एंड लिसनिंग टू यू नो सो मेनी इनक्रेडिबल म्यूजिशियंस इट्स ऑलवेज आई थिंक आई ट्राई टू यू नो गेट इंस्पायर्ड फ्रॉम थिंग्स दैट आई हियर एंड ट्राई टू काइंड ऑफ put into my system whatever little I can.
Wonderful. I mean, I know you had told me that you're not keeping too well.
Yes.
But if you're all right, would you like to hum a line or two for us before we sign out or anything that if you feel like, and if you don't, it's
not
a musical session.
Yeah, without music makes no sense. But will you do that favor for me and can I listen? The song that I heard, the first one. What was the name? Ishq Manaye Kya.
New one.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, I'll sing two lines of that. But before, you know, we conclude the session, I just want to ask Satyajit if I've missed out on any questions that came, because since I'm doing the session on the iPad, I don't think the questions were, I could see the entire chat box. Okay, Milinda, he has a question for Hargun, that you are a singer and you play several instruments and everyone has limited time for practice. What do you think about prioritizing vocal or instrumental practice?
This is a very good question, and it's like also a very it's also like a reminder for me, honestly. But as I said, you know, vocals obviously I would prioritize because that's the core subject for me. But playing instruments is, I won't say that is like a hobby thing, but I try to, whatever instrument I have in hand, I try to play it for half an hour, 45 minutes. Sometimes if I have more time, I would play more than an hour, 2 hours. Depends upon what it is. But of course, there is limited time. And there are so many instruments that I am trying to slowly, slowly learn. I don't know where I reach in future. But yes, Of course, I prioritize vocal practice because then that's the core thing for me.
Thank you, Milinji. Milinji himself is a wonderful flautist. And he joins the sessions. He's been a part of almost all the sessions and he makes brilliant questions as well. And he's a wonderful player. Thank you, Milinji, for joining the session. Yes. Namita, thank you. We love Nihira and Hargun too. These reality TV shows pick the best of the best. Thank you, Namita ji. Namita ji is a very sincere well-wisher and a follower and a beautiful person. And she's always there to support. So, okay. So, you wanted me to sing the newer version of Ishq Manaye Kya, right?
Yes.
Okay. I'll just do a really small jhalak of that. Mukhda. And I'll just play the track. A really quick version I'll do. And so, So basically, just talking a little about this song, this one melody that I composed back like in COVID, and I made it as a salsa first with a Cuban band. I could actually got in touch with a Cuban band and we turned it into a proper salsa the way a timba is. And now we've created a swing, a jive, a rock and roll version of it. So this, that one was done by Orquesta Son Diamantes, a Cuban band. And this one, I had Tanmay Pawar, Amit Gadgil on board. The lyrics are written by Manoj Yadav. And so I'll just sing a quick jhalak of that. Can you hear the track?
Yeah. I can. Yeah.
सुनिए ये दिल फरमाए क्या गुलशन इसकी कर दो कहिए ये नैन लड़ाए क्या बोलिए कुछ तो है हुजूर थोड़ा धड़कनों को डराए क्या सांसों को धमकाए क्या थोड़ी प्रीत थोड़ा प्यार बोलो से दिल में खिल क्या हम दोनों एक हो जाए क्या बात ये सबको बताए क्या पल भर दम लो सोच समझ लो इश्क बनाए क्या आग का दरिया बनाए क्या राज ये सबको बताए क्या केवल तुम हो केवल हम है इश्क बनाए क्या
वाह मेड माय डे
थैंक यू सो मच सो आई एम सॉरी आई डिडंट
I said it made my day.
thanks a lot. It's a
There's so much happening in the melody and you're just singing kuch nahi ho raha.
Are it, I mean when I was actually recording it in the studio I realized it's going to be difficult to perform this live because it's continuously going on. But that's the challenge. It's fun. So
yeah,
thank you so much for appreciating the song Hargun. And Milind has another question. I have another question for both of your reality shows. Most of the times, it is expected that the singers sing the already released songs as close as possible to the original singers. Okay. Whereas in studios, while recording originals, totally different experience and skill set is required. How do you both handle that?
You go first.
So, yes, it's a very valid question. What happened in my case is, before I got into reality shows, I had already started studio work. So I had, I wouldn't say a vast experience, but a fair amount of experience of learning a new song and interpreting it in my own way while I was already in the reality show. And now it's been like a long time since I did a reality show. But I think more than reality show, what Milinji is asking is, you sing a song that is already popularized by somebody else. And you're asked, that's what we do sometimes in live shows also. When we perform somebody else's songs, probably a classic, probably a contemporary. But what I at least try to do is because I cannot emulate or copy anybody. So I try to sort of close my mind and try to think of it as, okay, this is my chance of singing this song in a recording. I'm in the studio right now. Aur ye mujhe naya mila hai. Aur ab main isko kaise gaungi? And this is how at least I try to approach it. Because if I try to copy somebody else's style, I fail miserably. I just cannot do that. So exactly. This is the approach I chose. कि मैं उसको ये मेरा गाना है in the studio और अभी मुझको ये record करना है. ये सोच कर मैं उसको गाती हूँ. So this is how I deal with it. What about you, Hargun?
It's the exact same thing because even I fail miserably if I have to do the exact same thing. It's very very hard. You can and if you get very close to it. एक तो आई थिंक इफ यू डू योर ओन वर्जन ऑफ समथिंग then you people don't compare, and you know, you get out of that zone where people are comparing ki ye unhone waisa gaya tha tumne waisa gaane ki koshish kar di aur wo hua ya nahi hua, you are out of that already, because then they are judging you on your thought process in the song. And secondly, I mimicry is not a bad thing, I don't think, because a lot of things we learn as musicians is by mimicking at times. You know,
in fact that's how you begin.
That's how you begin, right? If you are exploring a new texture, you always have to kind of do that mimicking bit initially to be able to reach a point where you develop that own texture and make it part of your own system. So that is okay initially, but if you are just mimicking, then that's problematic, I believe. It doesn't have a value, because we already have legends who've sung those songs already, and iconic melodies by extremely talented people. They don't need mimics for that. So people around me in the reality shows, all the coaches we had and all the mentors we had, like both on screen and off screen, they always encouraged that originality and that own thought process in every song. So yes, that's my approach for the stage as well, for the live.
Satyaji just right now flashed that he's heard your singing of your version of Ramta Jogi, which I also heard just before our interview. I wanted to, you know, get a feel of your singing even more before we connected on live demi. So I was listening to Ramta Jogi, beautiful variations that you've done in your set in Mac Ka.
Thank you
really. Milind, for appreciating the song and the singing. Thank you so much for your questions also, and I would like to thank you, Hargun, for taking time out for this conversation. It was wonderful to get to know a younger mind, the thought process behind the person that you are, behind the musician that we see on stage and publicly.
Thank you so much. Guys, I feel absolutely inspired and refueled and recharged after talking to you and listening to Ishq Manaye Kya, especially. I had mentioned that.
Thank you.
thank you for having me.
So,
it has been a wonderful session. I really, really enjoyed it. We should do all of this more often.
Same here, Hargun. And I mean, someday I would like to hear you live. Aaj nahi mauka mil paya, but
definitely, let's do it.
Hear you live. We should do something together. And once again, I would like to thank Satyajit for creating this platform, Live Demi, and for curating this show, Kahani, through which I get to educate myself by these conversations, to be honest. Let me tell you, because when I talk to another mind, another musician, I'm getting to know their perspective, their journey, their struggles, and I pick up so much from their journey. So I would like to thank Satyajit for giving me this opportunity to,
and to me as well. He's been very kind
to interact with such nice musicians all the time. So
very, very passionate and very, very kind, helpful. And I just met him, I think, when I started playing Geo Shred. That was my initial first conversation, and our first conversation happened to be a very deep and long conversation, and there it's very, very inspiring to see someone passionately doing something like Live Demi, which is a gift to musicians in and around.
Absolutely. Nice. On that note, I think we should conclude this session. And I'm thankful to all the people who joined. Ashwin, Gulraj, Sharayu, and there was Milind also in the audience, and Namita ji, and everybody, Satyaji, and once again to you, Hargun. Hope to catch you soon.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Bye-bye.